Welcome to the ICE Framework video series. This series will help you understand the fundamental concepts you need to use ICE effectively. The first question is, what is ICE anyway? Well, ICE is an interactive creative environment for building all sorts of visual effects in Softimage. But at its core, ICE is simply a visual framework for creating custom operators. So the next question is, what's an operator? An operator is a modifier that updates data in the scene. For example, an operator can be used to simulate a particle system, create a sphere, extrude some faces, bend a mesh, apply a shape key, and so on. Operators can be applied one after another in a stack. Each operator modifies the result of the one below it. For example, the grid that's being used as a ground plane has two operators in its stack. First, the geometry operator at the bottom of the stack creates a basic grid. You can see its direct output if you temporarily disable the rest of the stack. Next, the turbulized mesh operator creates the uneven bumps on the grid. Operators have a persistent effect, meaning that they update automatically when data changes. For example, if you increase the subdivisions on the grid, you can see how the turbulized mesh operator automatically applies the same effect to the denser grid. ICE lets you create custom effects by combining basic math and logic to build your own operators. In fact, the turbulized mesh operator is actually an ICE tree itself, and you can open it up to see how it was built. Other videos will go into more detail about how to create the logic for controlling effects like this. But for now, let's clarify a few concepts about the operator stack itself. Start by creating a new ICE tree on the grid. You can see it added to the operator stack, but it doesn't do anything yet because there's nothing connected to the root ICE tree node. For this example, we'll use a pre-made compound called dent. As its name suggests, it creates dents in an object's shape using another object as a deformer. We'll use the foot as the deformer object. As the foot moves down, the ground underneath it gets pressed down, and the ground around the foot gets pushed up. However, if you play back and move the foot up again, the ground springs back to its original shape. That's because the operator is persistent and updates automatically when the foot moves. To have the ground stay deformed, you need to use a simulation. In a simulation, the effect is calculated using data from the previous frame instead of from the bottom of the stack. So if the ground was deformed on one frame, it stays deformed on the next frame, even if the foot doesn't intersect it anymore. To illustrate this point, create a simulated ICE tree on the grid. There you can see that the simulation and post-simulation regions have been automatically added to the stack. The different regions of the stack are used to organize operators used for different purposes. The simulation region is used for operators that update based on the previous frame, like fire or smoke effects. The post-simulation region is used to apply effects on top of the simulated result, such as using a lattice to make simulated particles squeeze through a keyhole. Move the ICE tree with the dent compound into the simulation region. If you go back to frame 1, you'll notice that the dent has stopped affecting the ground plane. That's because the simulation doesn't begin until frame 2. When there's a simulation region in an object stack, the operators below it get evaluated on the first frame to establish the starting point for the simulation. This is called the initial state. When you advance to frame 2, the dent starts affecting the ground again. When you play back, you can move or animate the foot to leave successive dents. However, if you pause the playback in the middle, you can't adjust the previous operators interactively. For example, adjusting the turbulence has no immediate effect. And neither does changing the subdivisions. That's because the regions below simulation are evaluated only on the first frame. When you return to frame 1, They update and become the new initial state of the simulation. So now you've seen how you can use ICE to create operators for customized effects, and how the operator stack works in Softimage. Subsequent videos will cover some of the other fundamental aspects of the ICE framework.